Good morning, everybody. Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. We are in the Ayurvedic College, Nigdi, Pradhikaran, Pune 44. Today is a Friday, that is 11th of October 2019. Myself is Professor Deshpande and I am here to teach you something about the Sharira Kriya theoretical aspect. Today's, as per the ATP planner, advanced teaching program, which is already circulated to the students. So they must have my advanced teaching program, and which is given date wise. All over India, or many of the teachers, they give month wise, but Professor Deshpande has given the date wise. And what is the purpose? The student is expected to come with reading that particular topic through my books, through my PPTs. I also circulate my PPTs 1 week advanced, most probably. There may be 1 or 2 days here and there, but most probably I try to send PPTs or the study material, including the audio. If somebody has given the good acknowledgement for that matter, can I ask how many of you have received my yesterday's audio clip, which was there on the mixcloud.com? Have anybody has received that? And has anybody has, please raise your hand, so that I get confident. Thank you very much. There are at least few students who are responding well to the Professor Deshpande's academic enthusiasm. Because this style is very rare. You can find, you go to the MBBS college, homeopathic college, Ayurvedic colleges, and you ask, how many of them teachers are doing this type of the protocol? Okay, so take the advantage, the enthusiasm and energy and the positive attitude towards the teaching program. So, today we are going to learn, the topic of today is Shat Kriya Kal. But as you know that, if the time permits, again my restriction is, if the time permits, Professor Deshpande like to start his lecture always with the Dhanvantari prayer. Okay, so we will chant the Dhanvantari prayer to begin with. Please sit straight for that matter. Sit straight. Don't expect, I am not expecting at all to stand. This is again a difference. You please try to notice these differences everywhere. Now, in the past and in the future, you will see in many seminars, in many workshops, in many guest lecture programs, there is always a hustle and bustle. Stand up, Dhanvantri prayer, stand up, stand up. I am totally against this attitude. Because it's more important, Professor Deshpande believes prayer is a meditation. Very slowly I have pronounced this sentence. Prayer is a meditation. What is meditation? Meditation means to look inside. To look inside. To understand oneself. Who am I? Yes, I am a student. What is my duties? What are my duties? So that understanding of self should happen during the meditation. But if you are just doing the mechanical job, okay, worship and standing and one eye open, one eye closed, the movement of the hands, tiredness, what hell going on, Sanskrit, then there is no interest or there is no meaning of chanting whatsoever. You may chant God prayer, you may chant Dhanvantari prayer, but if it has to be meaningful, it should be done in a peaceful manner, concentrating manner. Am I right or wrong? And that is why you will find 400 plus videos, audio videos on YouTube. And there is one video, I request all of you to go at home, open your internet, put the search engine Rajendra Deshpande on the YouTube, and then you will get Dhanvantari prayer meaning. Please see that video. I have explained the meaning of each and every word. I explained what is the meaning of Dhanvantari, why we should chant. Everything I have explained. But at the moment we don't have that particular period of that Dhanvantari prayer. So we will just chant that Dhanvantari prayer with sitting and comfortable position. Okay. Close your eyes gently. Take your hands near to the heart. So we are talking by emotions. Om. शंखं चक्रं जलौकां दधतमृतघटं चारुदौर्विश्चतुर्भिः सूक्ष्मस्वच्छातिरुद्यांशुकपरिविलसं मौलिमं भोजनेत्रं कालाम्बुदोज्ज्वलांगं कटितटविलसत् चारुपीताम्बराढ्यं वंदे धन्वंतरिं निखिलगदवन प्रौढदावाग्निनीलम् ओम शांति शांति शांति। बो योर हेड डाउन। नमस्कार। सैल्यूट टू गॉड धन्वंतरी द गॉड ऑफ हेल्थ। हेड अप। Slowly take your hands down. Slowly open your eyes. Warm up your eyes with the heat of the palm. Thank you very much. So I have already told you about the study material, especially for the newcomers. I repeat, there are the textbooks written by Professor Deshpande and some of the books. I appeal to all of you ethically. I make a little bit mandatory ethically again to purchase those books, which will be definitely useful to study your all the curriculum in a very lucid language and in a very comfortable language. The first book I will repeat, there is a Kriya Sharira paper 1. This is a textbook for part A. And most of my syllabus is covered over here. So this is from Shantanu Prakashan and everybody's. There are two parts, but at least part 1 should be purchased for Dr. Deshpande's periods or for the Deshpande's syllabus. Second book I have recommended, this is a handbook, Sharira Kriya Vidyan handbook, that is also with the Shantanu Prakashan. That will give the part 1, part 2, practicals, everything in a very short manner. That is a handbook. It's very easy to carry and I expect each one of you carry this handbook every day with you and go on from first word or first cover page to the last cover page. Go on reading, go on reading. Make it a parayana, repeated reading of that particular book, so that you will get minimum first class if you have all the book learned by heart. Learn by heart. Total jar tumcha paath asel tar tumhala 100% first class milu shakto only with this handbook. Third book I have recommended, Sharirik Kriya Vijnan Pratyakshika. That is also from Shantanu Prakashan. That is also expected to purchase. Then for the English medium students, there on the Amazon, you will get the Chaukhamba publication, a textbook of Kriya Sharir by Dr. Anade, Deshpande and Chobe Madam. This book is available on the Amazon for only English medium students. Then there is one book that I have forgot to brought, that is a clinical examination book. Anybody has that clinical examination book? But that is not of Shantanu Prakashan, that is from Narendra Prakashan. So you have to purchase that clinical examination book, which will be useful for first year, second year, third year and in your practice as well, because it is given how to examine the patient. Ashtanga Hrudaya handbook is also available of Shantanu Prakashan, and this also gives you in a very simple and lucid language understanding of the subject Ashtanga Hrudaya. Okay, so let us start with the period. Today's date I have mentioned that it is the 11th of October 2019 and the topic is the Shat Kriya Kal. Shat is a six. This is the Sanskrit word. I am repeatedly telling you, now you just concentrate on the screen, on my talking, because PPT is with you already. Never, don't worry, I will send you repeatedly. Marathi PPT is there, English PPT is there. This audio recording I am going to upload on the YouTube. So you can hear my lecture 100 times or n number of times. So nothing to be worried. So what is today's duty? Just focus. How I am talking, what I am talking, and look at the screen. Okay? So Shat Kriya Kal, Shat is a six. Kriya has two meanings. Kriya is activity, pathological activity in the body, number one. And Kriya is also the management, treatment part. And Kal is a time span. So we have the six periods. Whenever any disease comes, it is many times it does not come abruptly. Although we feel So from today morning, I started my loose motions. So where are the six stages? So it is not like that. Some one day before, 2 days before, 1 hour before, hour before, you have some grumbling in the abdomen. Uneasy feeling in your abdomen, in your chest, nausea, vomiting, something discomfort. That discomfort is also counted in this six. But that six period is not very specific. Six stages. For example, one stage can occur for 1 year. Second for second year. Third for third year. Another category, first stage for 1 month. Second stage for 1 month. So there is difference of time. And that comes up to the minutes as well. So within half an hour, all the six stages can be completed. Do you understand? For the 10 years, these six stages will be completed. And even half an hour, these six stages can be completed. Is it clear? So when it is completed in 10 years, that is a chronic disease. In medical language, it is called as a chronic arthritis, chronic asthma, chronic. But my loose motions today morning, acute. So in the acute, six stages will be completed first. In the chronic, six stages will be prolonged. Reference is Sushruta Samhita. You still might have been heard about all these compendia of the Samhitas. Basically, Charaka is the name of the person and name of the book. Sushruta, name of the person, name of the book. But, Vagbhata, name of the person, not the name of the book. Book name is Ashtanga Sangraha and Ashtanga Rudaya. Charak is the same, author, book. Sushruta, same, author, book. But Vagbhata, person, book, Ashtanga Sangraha, Ashtanga Rudaya. This topic is coming from the Sushruta Samhita. Charaka is said to be master of medicine. Sushruta is said to be master of surgery. But for PG students, it is very interesting to note, although Sushruta is a surgeon, he has mentioned many fundamental principles of physiology. Actually, he should mainly talk about the anatomy. But he is talking about also physiology principles. Like dosha, dhatu and mala. Next. This is the shloka. There are few shlokas in this particular context. So, it is important to go on reading. But, any student should not take too much stress, too much botheration, too much fear, too much phobia. Sanskrit, shloka. Don't worry. Be happy. This is Professor Deshpande's signal to you. Because 90% teachers of India, they force the Ayurvedic students, mug up the shloka, learn by heart. Shloka is all. This is 90% teachers make the depression, fear and phobia in the mind of Ayurvedic students. Only 10% like me are there who give the freedom. They explain. The shlokas are important in the sense, shlokas are very rapid revision. Only simple thing. In one line, if you remember the one line, you can write down the one page, a full page. So this is the advantage. So in spite of reading the full page, I am reading only one line. And that is why you try to learn by heart. Some will happen, some will not happen. Nothing to be worried about. If you don't write the shloka, you will be failed. Some type of this dhamkya. Warnings are given by the teachers, and that is very wrong according to me. Because when the patient comes to you, he will not ask you, tell me first shloka my of disease and then treat me. Is it like this? Tell me the samprapti of asthama and then only you are allowed to treat. This is not. This is for your own understanding, own computer. So this is all the programs that are in your mind and you work. Output is given with your treatment. So what is the shloka of Shat Kriya Kal? Sanchayancha Prakopam cha prasaram sthana samshrayam vyakti bhedi cha yovetti doshanam sa bhave bishak. So there are six stages. Sanchaya prakopa prasara sthana samshre vyakti and bhed. I have given you the warning at the first day. Don't get afraid of Ayurvedic terminology. Because when you enter for the BABS course, you are learning foreign language. I have already told you. Ayurvedic language is a foreign language for the students. Why? Because they are not exposed at the school level and college level. Allopathy language is not foreign language. Allopathy language is not foreign language. Why? Because you know from school level proteins, carbohydrate, fats, digestive system, respiratory, everything you know. Then you don't get shocked. But have you ever heard these words in your life previously? Samshraya, Prakop, Prasara? No. Why I should learn this topic? Because this is from Ayurveda. So Ayurvedic is a language, and for first 2-3 months only concentrate on remembering this terminology, that's it. And understand. Everything, other things will happen automatically. You will write your papers excellently. But the two important things, you must try to understand terminology, and understanding will be more important for the first year BMS. Okay, next. I have given little bit translation, although I have given mentioned as a equal to, but try to understand all Ayurvedic terms can be compared with the allopathy, compared with the modern English. But it should be remembered, it is not equal to, it is compared for better understanding only. I have also given this warning to you. Some orthodox teachers, examiners of Ayurveda, they get irritated when any student translates any Ayurvedic word in the modern language. If you say dosha, and in spite of dosha you say there are three bioenergies, they will be angry. They will give 0 mark. They will fail you. This is not at all happening. But try to understand. First you try to remember the original Ayurvedic word, and then for understanding purpose only, you go for the English translations. Okay? So Sanchaya, what is that? Stage of accumulation in their own sites. Vata, Pitta and Kapha. These are the bioenergies. They have their own territory where they should act. So different organs, for example, my upper part of the body, there is Vata, there is Pitta, there is Kapha. But predominantly, more Kapha activity is more seen over here. Middle part of my body, abdomen, umbilicus, intestines, there is Vata, there is Pitta, there is Kapha. But more predominant Pitta activity is taking place in the middle part, in my lower part. There is a rectum, there is a urinary bladder, there is a uterus, there are my legs. On the lower part of your body, there is Vata, there is Pitta, there is Kapha. But predominantly, Vata is more. Kapha on the upper part, Pitta in the middle part, Vata on the lower, predominantly. Vata, Pitta, Kapha exist everywhere. Everywhere. In each cell, in each organ, in each system, in each tissue, there is Vata, there is Pitta, there is Kapha, bioenergies. So, accumulation of the doshas in their own place is a sanchaya. Prakopa is a stage of aggravation. That means their quantity, quality and action, they increase still more. Still more. That is called as a prakopa. So it is a maximum level. I have given one example. Fortunately enough, when I am talking with you about Shat Kriya Kal, actually in India there is a rainy season, June, July, August, September. But you might have seen, at least in Pune, there was little rain in June, but heavy rain in July. Again little rain in August, but too much rain in the September. And still today, still yesterday, there is a lot of rain in the evening. Hasta Nakshatra. Do you know? Lot of rain is going on, and because of our mismanagement of the government, sanitary system, every roads are flooded. Do you understand? So there are dams for our water system. So when the rainy season comes, that dam starts filling. In the Grishma Rutu, in the summer season, in the hot season, it is dry. It is dry. When raining starts, gradually water level starts increasing. So beginning of the water level Maintaining is a sanchaya. When dams are full, that is called as a prakopa of the doshas. Are you getting example, simile? Prasara, stage of spread. Dam gates, the spelling is very wrong, I am sorry for that matter. G-A-T-E, darwaje, Marathi madhe. When the dams are full, what does government do? They open some doors. Otherwise the walls will fall, break. Okay? So they open the doors to carry that dam water into the rivers. Whenever there is excessive storage, they open the doors. You know this. That is the word. So whenever the doshas are maximum, kapha dosha, maximum in the my chest, too much, then it will spread to all other body parts, in the abdomen, in the legs. So that will start spreading their properties, functions and activities all over the body. Okay? That is called as a prasara. But this accumulation, excessive and spreading is not physiological. Try to understand. Shat Kriya Kal is regarding with the pathology, abnormal activity, disease process. Get it clear? Shat Kriya Kal is a pathogenesis, disease process. So all these things are the abnormal. So prasara, it starts spreading. Next. Sthana samshraya, stage of localization. Again, you can see the example. Flood has entered in the houses which are at a low level. When the river bank, you know, the river bank, there are some houses. And there are some houses or urban part which is away from the river. So that now the dam is full, gates are open, doors are open, water is flowing through the river. Who will get first, what you can say, the problem? Those houses which are very near to the bank, or those houses which are at a low level from the surface level. Am I right or wrong? And that you have already heard in the newspaper and the TV channels that a flood has entered in many societies. But is it in the all societies? No. Those who are built up in an unnatural way, hillside, when the water is coming from the hills, these are also entering into the houses. So whichever the part which is prone or which is delicate or which is abnormal, that gets problem. The weak houses, you know, the houses made up of the mud, jhopadapattya, slum area. Have you heard about that? So what is the problem? Where is the problem? It is not with the RCC construction. Of course, there are also problems with RCC construction who have not built up in a legal manner. They are also problems. So what I mean to say, this destruction is happening whichever the part is weak, whichever the part is abnormal. Similarly, when Vata, Pitta, Kapha are moving all over the body from top to bottom, they try to find where is the weak place, where is the weak place. W-E-A-K, weak means not strong, that is weak. I already explained about Dhatu Sarata. Rasa, Rakta, Mounds, Med, Asti, Majja, Shukra. Sarata means best quality. Uttama Sarata, Madhyama Sarata, Heena Sarata. When the quality of the tissue is less, naturally that tissue will be attacked by the doshas. And that is called as a Sthana Samshraya. Sthana means to localize. You can see vitiated dosha attack on the weaker tissue, that is Madhyama and Heenasara Dhatu, and at that particular stage, prodromal symptoms develop. Prodromal means warning signals. Prodromal means warning signal. For example, my Vata is a prakop and going into the head. So I will say, today my head is little bit getting discomfort. You understand my actions? Can you see my actions? Drama, that is more important while teaching. So Vata is going my head. Sometimes if my stomach is weak or intestines are weak, that Vata will go into my intestine. And I will say, I have some discomfort in my intestine. So what is that? According to the site, warning signals will develop. So when headache will show some symptoms, heaviness, you can get the attack of migraine. When you get the grumbling or sound in the intestine, you may get the diarrhea. So that is called as a warning signals will be developed as per the location, as per the site. Next. Vyakti. Vyakti means clear. Directly disease will formed. Okay. So Vyakti is a stage of manifestation. Diagnosis of the disease can be made. For example, your patient, your person, your client is suffering from IHD, ischemic heart disease. Ischemia, you know this word, less blood supply to the heart. Ischemia means less blood supply to the heart. Which arteries supply to the heart? Do you remember? Shabbas, very good. Sit down. The student has answered coronary arteries, very correct answer, right and left. So coronary arteries, when they get blocked, they cannot supply to the cardiac muscles, the blood. So less blood supply is ischemia and ischta. Stopping of blood supply, infarction. There are two words, ischemia, less blood supply. Infarct, stoppage of the blood supply. What is heart attack? Infarct. Is it clear? So here I have diagnosed the case, my patient has diagnosed, he has a ischemic heart disease. Clear? IHD. Vyadi, what you can do here? The doctor can do very specific treatment as per the disease. If the patient starts migraine, treatment will be migraine. If the patient starts diarrhea, the treatment of diarrhea. If the patient starts acidity, treatment of acidity. So that is called as a vyadhi. Vyadhi means disease. Pratyanika, very specific. Vyadhi pratyanika chikitsa. Chikitsa means treatment. Disease specific management can be given. I think here you can understand the importance of recording the lecture and putting it on the YouTube. What is the importance? You can hear my lecture on the YouTube as many times as you can. For example, if some words are not very clear at the moment, again here, you will get clear. Okay, RHD, I remember, sir has given explanation. So everything will be clear, not in this time. Not on the 11th of October, only 9 to 10. This will not sufficient, remember my word. Here only you get sensitization. Are you getting sensitization? Okay, wake up. This will only happen. Whenever somebody comes to you, Dr. Deshpande has taught you the Shat Kriya Kal. So your first answer should be yes. Whether you have completed your study? No. Because Vidya, study can never be completed. Knowledge can be understood, but if it has to be implemented, it has to be repeated many times. Understand my words. And why we are covering these big topics in 1 hour only? I have already given you the idea. This is not Deshpande's fault, or this is not any student or teacher's fault. This is the fault of, this is the media I am using, social media on the YouTube. I am little bit, with due respect to the CCIM and Ayush, I am little bit criticizing on these people. Why? Because first they have made a compression of 18 months syllabus of Sharir Kriya to the 12 months. And now their cutoff date today, I have found that it is 15th of October 2019 this year. But it may be extended, I don't know. But then what is my request as a teacher, field worker? There should be compulsion. Whenever the students get admitted, minimum he should have the 12 months and then only he has to appear for the exam. This is my personal opinion. Of course, there are a lot of students, different opinion, teachers, different opinion, because it has a more political issues. But I am, as an academician, as an educationalist, I say that if you want to learn very nightly and nicely, that all these things should happen in a very proper time. Otherwise, this is called as indigestion, very rapid eating. We are eating rapidly. But that's why at least Deshpande has given this, taken this opportunity to use the social media to put all these lectures and PPTs on the different internet sites, so that the students will not be afraid that my lecture has finished only in 1 hour. And that topic, actually I can give the seminar on Shat Kriya Kal for minimum one day. Try to understand. I can, Professor Deshpande can talk on Shat Kriya Kal. If real teaching should happen, I can talk for 8 hours minimum, I am saying. With lot of examples, with lot of questions and answers, personal attention. There are comments by the government. There is, you know, the medical medical teaching technology, something like that. There is a courses conducted by the MUH, how the teacher should teach. And what they are talking, you know, they say, the lecture should not be passive. See, big sentence. Lecture should not be passive means one directed. Lecture should be always interactive. Interactive. Do you understand? That means every time, after one sentence, I go to you, ask some questions. Then you will answer me. Then I will rectify. Then again I go to another student, he will answer. Then I will rectify. If I go on this way, I can complete only Shat Kriya Kal for the whole year. So try to understand, when the programs are made by the government, they should understand the problems in the field work. Otherwise they should not talk in that way. So the small group discussion should be there, one-to-one interaction should be there. This is possible if you manage your timetable accordingly. Okay, coming to the next point. Next. Bhed is a stage of differentiation. We have understood Sanchaya, Prakop, Prasara, Sthana, Samshraya, Vyakti, and now Bhed. Bhed is a stage of differentiation. So it is more specific on the dosha involvement. Which property of dosha is more disturbed? I have given one example. I have diagnosed my patient, that patient has a less blood supply to the heart, that is RHD. But I don't know how many arteries are blocked, how many coronary arteries are blocked, I don't know. In Vyakti, I understood only IHD. But in Bhed, when I perform angiography, this is for your PG students, when I perform angiography, you know this technique is there, angiography. The dye is passed through the femoral or something when, and then the dye is moving with the coronary arteries. And you can find out the blockages on the computer. At least you have heard about this. Am I right or wrong? Angiography. Angio means blood vessels. And graphy means passing the dye and seeing the picture on the screen. So angiography, you can understand one vessel disease. Whether one vessel is blocked. Two vessel disease. Two vessels are blocked. Three vessel disease. Three coronary branches are blocked. When three vessel disease, only surgery is possible. C, A, B, G, coronary artery bypass grafting. C, A, B, G, coronary artery bypass grafting. In a simple language, bypass. You know this operation, bypass. That blockade arteries are bypassed. Okay? So if it is only two blockages, two vessel block, then I can do angioplasty. You might have heard of this one. Angioplasty, to put some stent in the coronary artery, to put some stent and remove the blockages. If it is only one vessel disease, I recommend, in addition to allopathy, you can go for Ayurveda. One vessel disease, need not to go for angioplasty, need not to go for CABG. So that can be done in the Bhed Avastha. More details of the disease. I have given another example. Next. Now, these are some shlokas that you have to remember all the time. The textual, that means Sushruta has given some guidelines. These are not all, remember. He has given some examples of Sanchaya Avastha. What are the clinical features according to dosha? He has given some symptoms of Prakop Avastha. But remember, these are only examples. But for the first year BMS, these much examples are sufficient. So I am going to read this shloka for you. Tatra Sanchitanam Khalu Doshanam. This is the shloka of Chaya Avastha. Chaya Avastha. Stabdha Purna Koshtata. Pitav Bhasata. Mandoshmatacha Anganam. Gauravam. Alasyam. Chaya karana vidveshasyeti lingani bhavanti. This is the shloka. Linga. Here linga means symptoms. And the management, what should be done in this avastha? Chaya eva jayet dosham. Jaya means conquer, to win. If you want to win the disease, you should treat the patient in a very early stage. What you should remember in your practice? Whenever some complaints in your family members are started, you treat them immediately. Don't wait. No, no, let us wait for a few days and then we will do investigation. No, you have to treat very aggressively in the beginning. So when you treat the beginning, the problems are less and the treatment is more easy. So what is the today's take-home message at your home? That try to treat any complaint at the earliest. This is the final today's take-home message. Next. So this is the translation. Vata will create stabdha purna koshthata. That means filling of obstruction, stabdhata, and fullness in that particular organ. Then pitta will create the pitta, pitava bhasata. Pitta means yellow color. As you know, in the jaundice, eyes are your yellow. That is called the pitava bhasata. Kapha will create manda ushmata. Manda means low and ushma means heat. There will be low body temperature and low digestive fire. Then anganam gauravam. Anga means your body parts and gaurav means heaviness. Oh, I am too much tired today because it is all heavy. That is kapha. Okay. Then alasya. Alasya is a Marathi word. Alshipana. Alasya is a laziness because of the kapha that happens. Next. This is the shloka of prakopavastha. Tesham prakopat. Koshthatod sancharana amlika pipasa paridah annadvesho rudet kledascha jayante. Why I am reading this shlok? Again for the same thing. When you go home, when you hear my lecture with the headphones, you can skip your PPT in front and go on saying what is explained by Deshpande. Tesham prakopat koshthatod sancharana amlika pipasa paridah annadvesha rudayot kledascha jayante. Next. You can go out, madam. Please go out. Thank you very much. You can rest in your resting room, okay? Those who are feeling ill, they can go out of the class and they can rest for themselves. Huh? Nothing to be worried about. So, vata will create koshta toda. Toda is a pain. Remember this word. Toda is a pain. Then, sancharana is a hyperactivity of vata. Pitta will create amlika. Amlika means sore irritation. Pipasa, excessive thirst and polydipsia. Kapha will create, pitta will create paridaha. Daha means burning sensation. Kapha is creating annadvesha, that is anorexia, loss of appetite. Rudayot kleda, rudaya means this chest region. And kleda means like nauseating. You know, before vomiting, you get little bit discomfort in the chest. That is called as a nausea. Next. These are the symptoms of prasaravastha mentioned by Sushrut. Evam prakupitam prasaratam cha vayo vimargagamana atop osha chosha paridaha dhumayanani pittasya arochaka avipaka angasad chardishcheti kleshmano lingani bhavanti. Next. So what will create the vimargagamana? He will lost his normal tract. Like, you know, in the main transport chowk, if it is a traffic jam, what is happening? The small vehicle, scooter or any motorcycles, they try to find out the another road, bypass. So that is called as a vimargagamana. For example, my intestine should have the peristaltic movement and I should have the normal stools today. But in spite of that, I am having constipation and I am feeling something is coming up. So my vata activity is on the reverse direction, which is not normal. That is called as a vimargagamana. Then atopa is a typical sound created in the intestine. Now next are the, pitta I should mention. Pitta will create osha and chosha, that is different burning sensations. Paridaha is also burning and dhumayanani is also burning sensation as if some fumes are coming from your intestines or the stomach. Next. Kapha will create arochaka, loss of appetite, loss of taste sensation. Avipaka, paka means digestion, indigestion will be created. Angasada, sada means losing the pure power. Angasada. Whole body organs will see that loss of power is there. Chardi is a vomiting. Next. So, sthana samshraya, as I have mentioned, sthana samshrayana kriddaha bhavi vyadhi prabodhakam. Bhavi means future. Vyadhi means disease. And prabodham means to aware. Sthana samshraya stage will create some prodromal or warning signals. They will say that this particular disease may happen in your body. So that is sthana samshraya. Next. Vyadhi avastha, typical diagnosis. Here are the examples of three diseases. One is a pravahika. Pravahika is compared with the amoebic dysentery. When the patient complains, there is a pain in the intestines and lot of straining. And only little bit mucus is coming. Whenever you suffer from amoebic infection, amoebiasis, there is always straining. That is called as a pravahika in Ayurveda, pravaha manasya pravahika. Then kamala, kaman lati iti kamala. That means there is no desire of eating. Absolutely, I don't want anything. That is called as a kamala or the jaundice in modern infective hepatitis. Grahani is a chronic problem of the intestines where you get the stools. Muhur dravam, muhur baddam. Sometimes there will be loose motion, sometimes there will be constipation. Next. Vyakti avastha, disease specific symptoms. I have given already the same thing. Pravahika is a straining while passing the stools. That is a feature of amoebic dysentery. Atisar, what is the specific feature? Loose motions, that is diarrhea. Kamala, severe anorexia, which is a feature of infective hepatitis by virus A, which is called as a jaundice. Next. Again, dosha specific symptoms. For example, I am having the atisar or the loose motions. Whether my atisar is because of the vata predominance or pitta or kapha. So I have given the in detail. Only disease, vyakti avastha. But some details, bheda avastha. So vataja, loose motions with severe pain. Pittaja, loose motion when there is a blood. And kaphaja, loose motion when their stools contain froth. Frothy stools are there. Okay, next. Bheda avastha also indicates the chronicity of the disease. Any disease when it is a long term, for example in Ayurveda, it is said as a jirna jvara. Jvara means fever. So whenever any fever is more than 3 weeks duration, that is called as a jirna jvara in Ayurveda. So chronicity is also connected with the bheda avastha, that is the last stage. Next. So pathology in the ascending order. In Chaya, very less, 10% pathology. Prakopa, 30%. Prasara, 50%. Sthana samshraya, 60%. Then 80%. And bheda, 100% pathology. Everything is abnormal. So the pathology begins little more and more in from Chaya to last avastha, that is the bheda avastha. Next. So importance of Shat Kriya Kal, the first importance is arrest the pathogenesis in early stage. What is the Sanskrit word? Chaya eva jayet dosham. This sentence you will be asked in the last year of BMS in the subject of Kaya Chikitsa, internal medicine. In that paper they ask this formula. Explain. Chaya eva jayet dosham. What does that mean? Explain. So this topic is important for first year Kriya, second year pathology Vikruti Vidyan, and third year for the Kaya Chikitsa, that is internal medicine. For example, cancer in situ, any cancerous process going on, first time it is localized at particular region, breast cancer. It is only small nodule is there in your breast, especially for the females. So that breast cancer, when it is only located in a small space in the right breast or the left breast, very small. That is called as cancer in situ. Situ means that place. Cancer in situ. This is Chaya avastha or the Prakop avastha. Do you understand? But easy to treat than cancer with metastasis. When that cancerous cells go to your stomach, go to your liver, cancer is in the breast. But the cancer cells, where they are gone? They have gone in the intestine, they have gone in the liver. That is called as a metastasis spread all over the body, and that is incurable. First breast cancer, only over here, only nodule, small nodule, cut, complete mastectomy, complete remove the breast. You are 100% cure. The lady can save the life if the cancer is detected in situ. But when axillary glands are there, when your hair glands are there, liver is tender, sonography, metastasis, no use. No use. So that is the importance. Chaya eva jayet dosham. Next. Proper treatment at proper time. Chaya eva jayet dosham, we have already discussed. Sthana samshraya. If you improve the immunity of that particular organ, weak organ, madhyama sar, heena sar, if you build up the immunity, further process will be stopped automatically. It will not grow further. The disease will not stop over there. When you treat the organ and improve the immunity of that organ. Next, in Vyakti, disease specific treatment can be given. I have given the two examples. When you have the cough, only in the beginning you can treat with pippalyasav. Pippalyasav give the immunity to the respiratory tract, to the lungs, to the alveoli. But still, you have neglected, you start eating the ice cream, go in the wind, then that disease will go into the minuest bronchioles, alveoli, and you will get the pneumonia. Treatment will differ. First only pippalyasav, then specific treatment, shwasa kasa chintamani. Herbo mineral drugs you will have to use, herbo mineral. To begin with, only herbs, plants. But then you have to add some minerals. Then in the Bhed avastha, we have already discussed, when the heart attack, there are triple vessel disease, what you will have to go for? Operation. But if your diagnosis of heart problem, if it is earlier, only atherosclerosis, no blockages, then you can treat with Ayurveda also. You know the lipid, lipids is very sometimes dangerous because they block the arteries. So that blockages can be removed by Ovadi Gugulu. You have to give the patient Ovadi Gugulu for hyperlipidemia, blockages will be removed. Chaya eva jayet dosham. No block, one vessel, two vessel, three. No angioplasty. No bypass surgery, nothing. So this is the advantage. So what is finally you have understood in your mind? That Ayurveda has its special understanding about pathological process of the disease. Modern pathology has some its own ideas, but Ayurveda has also its own idea, which is called as a Shat Kriya Kal in Ayurveda. And what is the most important benefit? What you have understood in your life? That I have to treat the patient very earlier stages, so that the further pathology can be avoided, further complicated treatment, operations can be avoided. If you diagnose and if you treat the disease in Chaya Prakop Prasara Sthana Samshraya Avastha. If it is Vyakti and Bhed, complicated long-term treatment. I hope the basic understanding is very clear with you. Because of the time restraint, I have to conclude my lecture at this moment, because I have to take my presentee and some small discussions here and there, and then we will conclude. So total time period is nearly 48 minutes, nearly 50 minutes. So thank you very much for patience hearing. Today, that is on 11th of October 2019, Friday, 9 sharp in the morning, Dr. Deshpande has started his lecture, and around 9:57, doctor has concluded his lecture about Shat Kriya Kal. I request all the my listeners and the subscribers to subscribe my YouTube channel and also spread this message to your friends who have taken the admission in the Tilak Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya, Vagholi, Poddar, Nagpur, Nashik, Satara, wherever your friends of Ayurveda are there, you please tell them about my activity and get their support also, so they will be also get benefited. At least all these activities at the moment, they are free of cost and charitable. So you must take the advantage of this YouTube, SlideShare, Mixcloud, etc. So thank you very much. Have a nice day ahead.